Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Early Saturday morning, SpaceX successfully launched their 84th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 628.
Lift off of Starlink, go Falcon, go Starlink.
The boost which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1, landing confirmed.
SpaceX were planning to launch another Starlink mission earlier this morning, but it was delayed by a day. The Starlink 77 mission is now scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 20th at 6:33 a.m. UTC or 1:33 a.m. EST. Coming up this week, we can hopefully expect to see another Falcon 9 mission launch. The Starlink 629 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 22nd at 4 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 21st at 11 p.m. EST. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on expanding the Star Factory production building. Work also continues on the wall around the suborbital test site. It looks like Starbase may get another launch tower in the not too distant future. Starship Gazer posted a picture and said second piece of a new Starship orbital launch tower just arrived from Florida. There were a couple of posts from SpaceX prior to the Starship flight test. The first said, while it's not happening in a lab or on a test stand, this is absolutely a test. What we are doing today will provide invaluable data to continue rapid development of Starship. Then the second post said this rapid iterative development approach has been the basis for all of SpaceX's major innovative advancements, including Falcon, Dragon and Starlink. Originally supposed to launch on Friday, the Starship IFT2 launch had to be postponed a tad bit. Musk explained why by saying we need to replace the grid fin actuator, so launch is postponed to Saturday. Then, on Saturday, SpaceX finally launched the long-awaited second integrated flight test of Starship.
4, 3, 2, 1. We have the bus. Vehicle pitching down range.
Ultimately, it was a pretty successful test, having made it through stage separation, followed shortly after by a Booster 9 rudd and a little later a Ship 25 rudd.
And acquisition of Houston, signal Houston and New Orleans.
Booster engine cutoff. Stage separation.
Boost main startup.
Ship engine ignition.
We're hearing the cheering. The first ever successful hop stage for SpaceX's Starship.
SpaceX posted this video and said congratulations to the entire SpaceX team on an exciting second integrated flight test of Starship. Starship successfully lifted off under the power of all 33 Raptor engines on the Super Heavy booster and made it through stage separation. They posted information after the launch. The first post says the booster experienced a rapid unscheduled disassembly shortly after stage separation while Starship's engines fired for several minutes on its way to space. Then they posted another saying, with a test like this, success comes from what we learn and today's test will help us improve Starship's reliability as SpaceX seeks to make life multiplanetary. They also posted these cool pictures and said Starship launches off the pad under the power of all 33 Raptor engines on the Super Heavy booster. Then they posted even more pictures of this incredible launch. They said Starship liftoff through successful hot stage separation. SpaceX also posted this cool video of the Starship launch. They said Starship liftoff in slow motion. There was information posted related to the Artemis missions and Starship. It says SpaceX will use both Starbase and LC-39A launch pads for Artemis 3 HLS, in the high teens of number of launches needed to aggregate fuel. Lander is about halfway through that sequence. Must do all in quick succession due to boil-off issues. After the launch of Starship, John Krause posted a picture of the orbital launch mount and Musk responded. John said the orbital launch mount at Starbase appears to be in good shape following today's flight test of Starship. Musk responded with, "Launch pad is in great shape. I wanted to share this awesome picture from Astronomy Live of the top half of Starship after FTS was triggered." In response to Scott Manley about capturing large debris from the ship, this post from Astronomy Live says, "Sure did. Looks like the front fell off." There were some posts from a SpaceX employee about the possible causes of the booster and ship rapid unscheduled disassembly. The first says, "Lots learned, lots to do. Booster rudd could have been prevented had there been more checked precautions. No one knows the full story yet, however some theories on engine failures late into the ship's burn are beginning to gain some traction." They were then asked, "What's happening on booster?" The response was somehow, somewhere there was a miscalculation in how fast the booster would flip after staging, which probably did not account for the radial force that the ship's burn would put on the stage. The boost back burn starts when the booster is at a specific orientation. It reached that orientation too rapidly, which caused a major fuel sloshing event, in turn starving half of the engines of fuel. Downcomer eventually ruptured for the third time, which prevented proper flow to the remaining engines, triggering automated flight termination system. As always, I have to say thanks to both Sean Doherty and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.